Hello, I'm Vanessa Allen Sutherland, chairperson of the U.S. Chemical Safety Board, with a safety message. Summer vacation is winding down for America's students, and back to school season is upon us. Both children and teachers are preparing for the new school year. As a mom, I know how busy this time of year can be, but for a moment, I'd like to talk about the importance of safety in the classroom. There have been a number of serious incidents over the last decade in which classroom science demonstrations have resulted in fires and injuries. These demonstrations typically use methanol or other flammable liquids as a fuel for combustion.
I'm CSB board member Kristen Kulinowski, and together with our staff, I've been gathering information about classroom incidents. The most recent was in May 2017 in Houston, Texas, where 12 preschool students were burned during what is known as the Rainbow Demonstration. This demonstration produces different colored flames by burning various mineral salts dissolved in a flammable solvent. When one of the colors could not be seen, the teacher poured additional methanol in an attempt to make it burn brighter. But this caused a flash fire that injured the nearby children. That incident is nearly identical to the one profiled in the CSB's video safety message after the rainbow. That video features Kelly Weber, a young woman who was burned on over 40% of her body during a performance of the rainbow demonstration at her Ohio high school in 2006.
In response to three separate incidents that injured both children and adults over an eight-week period in 2014, the CSB issued a safety bulletin titled Key Lessons for Preventing Incidents from Flammable Chemicals in Educational Demonstrations. Our safety bulletin provides four key lessons learned from the three 2014 accidents. Do not use bulk containers of flammable chemicals in educational demonstrations when small quantities are sufficient. Implement strict safety controls when demonstrations necessitate handling hazardous chemicals, including written procedures, effective training, and the required use of appropriate personal protective equipment for all participants. Conduct a comprehensive hazard review prior to performing any educational demonstration, and provide a safety barrier between the demonstration and audience.
When performed safely, classroom demonstrations can be exciting and encourage students' interest in science. The CSB believes that with better attention to good safety practices, serious accidents can be avoided. Demonstrators should prepare by asking themselves, what could possibly go wrong here? And is the benefit worth the risk?
Students and teachers should not be in harm's way in the classroom. It is our hope that our lessons will be more widely adopted so that during this upcoming school year, no one is injured during classroom demonstrations.